Firstly, it's not just a piece of clothing. Each part represents something. These five buttons right here down the front represent the five pillars of Islam. Shahada, the Muslim profession of faith. Salat, prayers five times each day. Zakat, charity to benefit the poor and the needy. Puasa, fasting during the month of Ramadan. And Hajj, the Muslim pilgrimage to Mecca. However, when you see a single button on another version of the baju, it represents Islamic Tawhid, or oneness of God. Each baju pocket respectively represents Islam, faith, and Ihsan, which means perfection. Sampin, a piece of woven cloth, is usually tied around the waist of the wearer of the baju Melayu. The cloth also has a deeper meaning, in that it may represent your relationship status. Wearing your sampin below your knees means you're married. Above your knees, you're still single and looking. If you're already married and still wearing a shorter sampin, you might be looking for a second wife. So where does baju Melayu come from? Let's take it back to 700 years ago, back in the 15th century. Sultan Muhammad Shah, a royal member of the state of Malacca, had many philosophies on the topic of fashion. The Sultan wanted an attire to be worn specifically for royal families and dignitaries to stand out when they meet the king and queen. You might remember that way back then, Malacca was the center of trade, with a constant flow of traders from all over the world. The inspiration for the shirt actually came from the Egyptians, who wore a loose cotton shirt called the jalabia, also known as the juba. The bottom can be the traditional sarong, or pants, which were a Turkish influence. One thing is for certain, the baju Melayu and what it represents is so unique and deeply rooted in Malaysian cultures and beliefs that it is able to evolve with modern fashion standards and bridges the gap between Malay cultural identity and the Islamic religion.